What are the typical tools and technologies used in microservices architecture? The typical tools and technologies used in microservices architecture include containerization platforms like Docker and Kubernetes, service discovery tools like Consul and Zookeeper, message brokers like RabbitMQ and Apache Kafka, API gateways like Kong and Istio, and monitoring and logging tools like Prometheus and ElkStack. How do you ensure that microservices are communicating with each other correctly and efficiently? To ensure that microservices are communicating with each other correctly and efficiently, you can use protocols like REST, gRPC, or messaging patterns like publish-subscribe. Service discovery tools can also help in dynamically discovering and routing requests to appropriate microservices. How do you monitor and manage microservices in production environments? To monitor and manage microservices in production environments, you can use tools like Prometheus and Grafana to monitor metrics and performance, logging tools like ElkStack or Fluentd to manage logs, and container orchestration platforms like Kubernetes to manage and scale the microservices. How do you handle database transactions across multiple microservices? To handle database transactions across multiple microservices, you can use distributed transaction management systems like two-phase commit or sagas. You can also use event-driven architectures where changes in one microservice can trigger events that are consumed by other microservices. How do you design microservices to be fault-tolerant and handle failures gracefully? To design microservices to be fault-tolerant and handle failures gracefully, you can use techniques like circuit breakers, bulkheads, and timeouts. You can also design microservices to be stateless and idempotent so that they can recover from failures quickly. How do you ensure the security of microservices and their communication channels? To ensure the security of microservices and their communication channels, you can use techniques like encryption, authentication, and authorization. You can also use API gateways to manage access control and rate limiting. How do you handle versioning and backwards compatibility of microservices APIs? To handle versioning and backwards compatibility of microservices APIs, you can use techniques like semantic versioning and API versioning. You can also use API gateways to manage different versions of APIs. How do you handle performance issues that may arise due to increased network communication in microservices architecture? To handle performance issues that may arise due to increased network communication in microservices architecture, you can use techniques like caching and load balancing. You can also use container orchestration platforms like Kubernetes to scale microservices horizontally. How do you handle the complexity of inter-service dependencies in a large-scale microservices architecture? To handle the complexity of inter-service dependencies in a large-scale microservices architecture, you can use techniques like domain-driven design, event-driven architectures, and bounded contexts. You can also use service meshes like Istio to manage the communication between microservices. How do you handle testing of microservices, both individually and as a part of the larger system? To handle testing of microservices, you can use techniques like unit testing, integration testing, and contract testing. You can also use tools like Docker to create isolated test environments for each microservice.